In this video, I am going to discuss the different approaches to perform an array rotation. We have an array consisting of integers of size n and a positive integer of rotation count r. We are allowed to shift each of the array's elements by one position. We have to perform left or right rotation in an array. For example, let's suppose a given array is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Array rotation simply means shifting the array elements to the left or right of the array by specified positions. Let's suppose if two left rotations are performed on a given array, then the array would become 3, 4, 5, 1, 2. Or let's suppose if two right rotations are performed on the given array, then the array would become 4, 5, 1, 2, 3. Here I am listing 6 different approaches with its time complexity and auxiliary space used by an algorithm. Later on, we will see how the time complexity and auxiliary space of algorithms is calculated step by step. The approaches which we are going to discuss are brute force, using temporary variable, using auxiliary array, juggling algorithm, reversal algorithm, block swap algorithm. These four algorithms, that is 3, 4, 5, 6, are the type of block swap method, and the time complexity of each algorithm is linear, that is big O of n. Now let's understand the concept, algorithm, and implementation of each listed approach by one by one. Approach 1, brute force. The first approach is brute force approach. This is a straightforward approach in which rotate all the elements by one position towards left direction for r times, where r is the rotation count. Algorithm. Start the execution of the program. Declare two variables prev and temp such that it will be used for shifting of the elements. Repeat the steps for r times for these steps. Initialize variable prev with the last element. Repeat the steps until j equal to n in ascending order for these steps. Initialize variable temp with the element of the array at location j. Update the element of the array at location j with the variable prev. Update the variable prev with the temp value. Stop the execution of the program. Let's find the time complexity of this algorithm. For that, we have to analyze the time complexity of each step and then add them together to get the final time complexity. Let's combine these individual steps of time complexity together to find the algorithm time complexity. Now here, dropping the constant time, that is big O of 1. Since 3 number is also a constant in this case, so dropping it, this big O of r into n is the time complexity of this algorithm. Let's find the auxiliary space of this algorithm. As we can see, the prev and temp are the only auxiliary variables having fixed space at any given execution of time. That is, the space will not get changed with the increase in the inputs. Therefore, auxiliary space is a constant which is represented as big O of 1. This is how the time complexity and auxiliary space of the brute force approach is calculated. For right rotation, the algorithm would become initialize variable prev with the first element. Repeat the steps until j equal to n in the descending order. Example. Let an array is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we have to rotate this array by 2 positions towards the right direction. Therefore, we will iterate the array for 2 times, that is 1 and 2, and rotate the array using temporary variables, that is prev and temp. Let's begin with the first rotation. Initialize the prev value with the last element of the array, that is 5. Now start iterating the array for rotation count 1. Store the current element in a temporary temp variable, that is 1, and update the current element with the prev variable, that is 5, and then update the prev element with a temp variable, that is 1. Now move to the next element and repeat the same step until the iteration of first rotation finishes. As we can see, the iteration of first rotation has finished now. Let's begin with the second rotation. Initialize the prev value with the last element of the array, that is 4. Now start iterating the array for rotation count 2. Same as before, store the current element in a new temporary temp variable, that is 5. And update the current element with the prev variable, that is 4, and then update the prev element with a temp variable, that is 5. Now move to the next element and repeat the same step until the iteration of second rotation finishes. As we can see, the iteration of second rotation has finished. Finally, after performing 2 iterations, the array is rotated by 2 positions towards the right direction. Let's look at the implementation of this algorithm for both left and right rotation of an array. This brute force approach to rotate the array is the simplest approach but not the efficient, as it rotates all the elements by 1 position. These are the 2 arrays on which we have to perform the array's rotation towards left or right. The rotation count is 2. These are the function called to actual implementation of the algorithm and assigning the result array to its initial array. This function is used to print the array after rotation. This for loop prints each array elements one by one. Now let's look at the actual implementation for right rotation. This is used to handle if the rotation count is greater than or equal to the array length, such that it speeds up the rotation. This temporary variable are used for shifting of the elements. This outer for loop is used to iterate the array for given rotation count times. Initialize variable prev with the last element. This inner for loop is used for shifting the array element towards the right direction using temporary variables. Now let's look at the implementation for left rotation. This would speed up the rotation if rotation count is greater than or equal to the array length. This temporary variable are used for shifting of the elements. This outer for loop is used to iterate the array for given rotation count times. Initialize variable prev with the first element. This inner for loop is used for shifting the array element towards the left direction using temporary variables. I hope you understand the logic behind this algorithm. Thank you for watching.